Moving on, the Philippine Bureau of Immigration expecting an increase in human trafficking cases after the holiday season. BI spokesperson Dana Sandoval explains the high demand for travel this season is making it challenging for traffickers to book tickets out of the country. Still, the agency records around 10 to 15 trafficking attempts amid the travel rush. But that figure is way higher during the regular season.
Maybe around 60 in a day, we could see several attempts of illegal recruitment victims, human trafficking victims, trying to go out of the country with spurious documents or pretending to be regular tourists. I guess there's always the temptation maybe for these people to be able to earn some money in assisting, escorting, recruiting human trafficking victims. And at the same time, the victims themselves are continue to say yes to such offers, despite them knowing that it's wrong, it's illegal, it's dangerous even.
Now, just last week, an airport employee was caught helping three human trafficking victims who attempted to depart from Fort Dubai, that is. The incident is now under investigation. All right, moving on. Only half of previously interested bidders have formally submitted bids to rehabilitate the country's main gateway, the Ninoy Aquino International Airport. Let's bring in our correspondent, Jackie Pascual, for more details on that developing story. Hi, Jackie.
Hi, good afternoon, Stanley. Four groups have submitted their bids for the operations, maintenance, and upgrade of the Ninoy Aquino International Airport. Eight groups earlier bought bid documents, but only half submitted a bid before the 10 a.m. deadline of December 27. The Department of Transportation said the four groups which submitted bids are the Manila International Airport Consortium, Asian Airport Consortium, GMR Airports Consortium, and SMC SAPN Co. Notable conglomerates joining the bidding are Aboitiz Infra Capital, Ayala's AC Infrastructure Holdings Corp., Alliance Global Infra Corp., Phil Invest, JJ Summit Holdings, who are among the groups forming Manila International Airport Consortium. Asian Airport Consortium, meanwhile, is formed with Costco Capital Inc., Asian Infrastructure and Management Corp., Philippine Skylanders, and Indonesia's Angkasapura. GMR Airports, meanwhile, has operated the Mactan Cebu International Airport, and now it is joined by the Yuchenko-led House of Investments and the Cavitex Holdings in the NAIA project. SMC, or San Miguel Corporation, meanwhile, is building the new international airport in Bulacan. Transportation Secretary Jaime Bautista said he is very excited to work with a winning bidder, which they will announce in the first quarter of 2024. Today, the opening of bids was held, and Bautista said that they will check the technical qualifications and financial aspects in the weeks to come. Bautista again reiterated the need to upgrade NAIA, saying it is already congested because it only has a 32 million annual passenger capacity, but already it hit nearly 15 million passengers. With the rehab project, he expects annual passenger capacity to reach 60 million. And that's right, Stanley, back to you.
All right, thanks a lot for the update, Jackie Pascual. EV giant Tesla set to launch a revamped version of its Model Y from its plant in Shanghai. Mass production is expected to start by mid-2024. Now, the new version of the Model Y will reportedly have much more obvious exterior and interior changes. The development comes as Tesla's domestic rivals accelerate product launches amid heated competition. First rolled out in 2020, the Model Y is among the best-selling EV models worldwide. American AI startup Anthropic projecting a huge windfall for the company in 2024. Now, reports are saying Anthropic is projecting it will generate more than $850 million in annualized revenue by the end of the year. That's a huge leap from the company's prediction of $500 million just 3 months ago. Now, some people close to the company even believe Anthropic could reach $1 billion in annualized revenue next year. The San Francisco-based firm was co-founded by former executives at Microsoft, backed rival OpenAI, and siblings Dario and Daniela Amode. The world's biggest nuclear plant located in Japan set to begin a process towards restarting operations. Now, Japan's nuclear power regulator on Wednesday lifted an operational ban on the massive Kashiwazaki-Kariwa power plant. The facility, which has a capacity of over 8,200 megawatts, has been offline since 2011 when the Fukushima disaster prompted the eventual shutdown of all nuclear power plants in Japan at that time. The Tokyo Electric Power has been eager to bring it back online to slash operating costs. But a resumption still needs the consent of locals in the Niigata Prefecture. The U.S. extends tariff exclusions on over 300 Chinese import products until May 31, 2024. The inclusions, or exclusions rather, were set to expire on December 31st. Now, this covers industrial components such as pumps and electric motors, some car parts, bicycles, and vacuum cleaners. COVID-related exclusions were also extended, covering face masks and gloves. The U.S. Trade Office said the extension will allow for further consideration under a statutory four-year review. The Trump administration, invoking Section 301 of the Trade Act of 1974, first launched the China tariffs in 2018. The tariffs on hundreds of other Chinese products remain under the Biden administration. A Philippine House lawmaker files a bill which seeks to regulate the use of artificial intelligence in the labor industry. Quezon City Representative Juan Carlos Arjo Ataide filed House Bill 9448. It bans the use of AI or automated systems to replace human workers unless an equivalent alternative employment opportunity is made available. It also prevents employers from making decisions based solely on recommendations or results generated by AI. The bill, though, won't apply to industries or positions where AI is deemed necessary for safety, efficiency, or the overall benefit of society.